Bonjour, good morning, good day, good afternoon, of course, depending where you are watching us from. This is Rope for Hope talk show brought to you by One Africa Radio TV, hosted by myself, Dr. Hope Machimansibui. This is the show where we say we will give you the rope to pull you out from the pit and ask you not to cut the rope, but also to extend to someone so that you can also pull them out. Today, before I introduce to you our today's guest, please do subscribe, like, comment, and press that notification button so you don't miss any of the happening in our channel. Back to our regular program. Our today's guest, oh my goodness, he's a professional actor, musician, songwriter, record label owner, businessman, and a third Dan Karat Sensei. I promise you, this is going to be a jam packed show. Family, help me welcome the one and only Colin the General. Boo, 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 boo. How do we do, Jen? How did it? Boo, boo. There we go. Welcome to the show, sir.
Dr. Hope, thank you for having me on your show.
Yes, yes.
Greetings to the viewers.
Exactly. You are here today. I'm so honored to really host people like you. You know, you are those people that we go out and look and look and look and find and search and find. But thank you really for coming.
No, thank you.
I've said so many titles about you. But yes. Who is Colin?
Oh, Colin the General.
Colin the General, Colin, yeah. General. I must not forget the
Don't
General.
Forget the General. Yes. Colin was born in KZN.
Okay.
Yes, Edumbe precisely.
Edumbe?
Edumbe.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
It's a small town next to Freyet, yes, so that's where I'm from.
Okay.
Yes, in the family.
I'm from KZN spiritually, though, in the spirit.
You have to.
Yeah.
You have to.
Okay.
Yes. So, yeah, I was born and raised there and in a family of eight.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, then up until I finished high school, then I came to Joburg.
Your original name is Colin?
My original name is Colin.
The General?
Yes, here comes the General. The General was given to me by the guys in studio through the music journey.
Oh,
so, yeah. The reason why I was given the name is because of taking charge every time where I go, I take charge. So even in the studio, when they trying to give directions and stuff, I always take charge.
Guys, please be careful he will
make
sure he put order here.
So that's where the name came from.
So basically you are creative.
I'm very creative.
And you are a problem solver, because if they say to you General, it means wherever you find a problem, you basically put everything
together.
I
can make things easier.
Growing up in a family of eight kids, how was it in terms of the family structure? Out of all the eight kids, who what number were you, and how was your upbringing?
Okay, in the family, I'm the fourth one.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and we were those kids that were raised in a way that we have to accept the situation as it is.
Okay.
So, meaning, as you look at it, maybe saying in a family of eight, how can somebody raise eight kids at the same time?
Mm-hmm.
You know. So, as for us, we didn't see any difficulties. Although, if I look at it now, I'm like, yeah.
Would you wish to have eight kids? Would you wish to have eight kids?
Yeah. So that was the family.
Yeah.
So, the way things are now.
Yeah. You can't have eight kids.
No, it's very difficult. So by then, we didn't see any problem.
Yeah.
We were just kids. We were happy accepting whatever was in front of us.
And of course, eating anything. I mean,
anything.
We didn't have that choice of rice and what. No, Lisa, it's like, it's natural food.
The only thing I remember about it is the happiness that was there.
Oh, come on.
The happiness because of us being so many in the family, so we didn't need any other kids to play. even other kids outside were looking at us like, this is where we're supposed to be.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Were you those kids that, for example, when it's breakfast time, I remember in our olden times, they will call all of us and they will buy like a loaf of bread and they'll be cutting with hands. Take tata wena, tata wena. Yeah, did you grow up where you...
That
you
was eat? The difficult part of this.
And you hide meat.
Yeah, that was
behind.
The difficult. You have to be quick. You have to be quick. Always, always being alert when it's that time.
Mm.
Yeah, because anything can happen. But still happy though.
Oh, wow.
Still happy.
You, all the titles that you have, there's one that is really getting to me, a Karat Sensei. Are you...
That's my home.
Oh.
That's my home.
Okay.
Yes.
So you can kick some kicking, like some wah-ha.
Yep.
Oh my God.
Yep. Yeah.
Let me pull myself backwards a little bit. So how, what inspires you to do that?
Two things.
Yeah.
One, it was the bullying in primary.
Oh.
Two, watching movies, obviously. watching movies, obviously. So there was too much bullying when you're studying at primary, so always you have to defend yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I was that kind of small boy who really didn't want to depend on someone, like older brother, older sister. I have to do it on my own, because if they are not there, so what I'm going to do?
Yeah.
You see, so that was the other reason, so, and the movies as well.
So it inspired you.
Yes,
also.
And imagine at the age of 10.
You started at the age of 10?
At the age of 10.
So you have those belts. I hear there's a black, white, what, some belts, or you just love doing it?
There's a long way you have to go before you get there.
Okay.
To the black one. I know people just know.
Oh, I thought you would just do that and get a black belt.
There's few colors you have to do before that one.
Oh, okay.
Yes, and okay. Obviously, depending on your performance.
Mm.
Yes.
Awesome.
So, yeah.
But moving from KZN coming here, what were you coming to do in Johannesburg?
There was a lot of things in mind.
Mm-hmm.
One, maybe thinking that maybe when I get here, I might be able to do some hustle, continue with the school, looking for a job, obviously. And the entertainment was in my head.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so you came to Joburg for your music career.
Music career.
And how did it go?
Acting career. It wasn't the way I was expecting that it's going to be. There was a lot of difficulties.
Mm.
A lot. We can go on and on and on, but yeah, there was...
Give me one of those challenging moments that you felt life, it's not fair.
Firstly, when I came into Joburg, you know, I didn't know how people live around Joburg, you know.
Because this you are thing, used to...
I'm used to be at home where we pay no rent.
Eish.
You know, so coming here, seeing that every time you step out of your door, you have to be, you have to pay someone. You know, so those were the challenges. I didn't know about all of that, so I was told to be on my own. After 3 months, I was here. You know, knowing no one. You don't even know the area that you are
in.
So
yeah,
those were the difficulties. So I have to put aside all those things that were in my head and try to readjust now, knowing the area, and now know where to hustle, because now I'm on my own. I must know how to pay rent. I must know where the last meal will come from, and all of those stuff.
Were you working in order to pay rent, or? What was your first income, and where did it come from? From what were you doing for your first, in order for you to really pay rent? And because somebody can be looking at you and say, hey, this guy is a big guy. But when we talk of those struggles, that's where somebody who's struggling right now, they need to understand that it's a process.
So that's where the karate thing came in handy.
Okay.
Yes, because... Okay. As soon as I arrived in Joburg, I managed to join the team quickly.
Mm-hmm.
So that one helped me to know some other guys in the area.
Mm-hmm.
Two, some of them were appreciating my job that I was doing in the gym because they didn't have anyone with my experience in the gym. So now, in order to keep me there, some of them will obviously
give you me something. Yeah.
And some of them, obviously, I get a chance to know them, speak to them, and explain my situation that I need a job.
So, from what you're saying, it's ringing in my mind to say some of the challenges that you have in life is actually pushing you towards your greatness. Because if you were not bullied, you wouldn't do what you did.
Yeah.
And the same thing, it gave you your income.
Yes.
And what did you survive in Johannesburg? Something that you say, hey, I cannot forget that day. Maybe somebody tried to say, later. Or what is the greatest thing that you say, yeah, life has taught me good?
Being on the streets.
You stayed on the street?
Yes, being on
you
the
street. You lived on the street?
Yes, because remember when I was told to be on my own.
Yeah.
It wasn't going to be a minute thing that I'm going to go outside and find a place to stay. I'm going to go outside and get the money for that.
Okay, hold on. You're saying staying in the street.
In the street.
You know, it feels like when you say staying in the street, you mean like you were in a flat or something. Are you saying sleeping like in the bridges or not knowing where to sleep when it's late?
Not knowing where to sleep when it's late. So you have to find a way home.
Oh my God. And how is the treatment like there? When I work in the street and walk around the street, I see these guys, they look so united and so protective of each other. Is that how you guys live? Or is that one man for himself, God for us all?
Out there, it depends on how you handle yourself and mm-hmm. knowing where you're going.
Yeah.
That's why you see the difference amongst them. There's some people that are sleeping on the street as we speak, but you won't even know that they have no place to sleep.
Oh my goodness.
It's like that. So you have
survive that life? What or when was your turnaround? Were you like,
I didn't stop the hustle. And
oh, okay.
I didn't forget the goal. So.
So you were still doing karate at the gym, sleeping on the street?
Exactly.
Are you for real?
For real. So that's how you handle yourself.
Oh my goodness. And you're still continuing living every day. You never thought of going back home?
Never. What will surprise you, I'll even lie. Maybe
at
when
home.
I get a call from home, are you okay? And I will say, I'm perfectly fine.
I ate well.
Knowing
slept
exactly
well.
That.
Oh my goodness.
When the sun set, I don't have a place to sleep. I don't even know what to eat. But I'll just say I'm perfectly fine.
Oh, because you wanted to pursue something.
Exactly.
And knowing
the situation back
at
home.
So
I remember leaving home, coming to Joburg. For them, it was something big. So they have that hope.
Oh,
when he comes back, things will
failed.
Change. You see, so I have to continue giving them that hope that I'm okay. And I'm doing exactly what they are expecting me to do.
Oh my goodness. So are you saying it's not everybody on the street that left home because they were naughty or whatever? Because I think that's the perception that we have to say when we see the street kids, you know, we're thinking, mababuyele ekhaya laba, they ran away.
No, not everybody.
So they are here to hustle.
They are here to hustle. So then along the way, then some of them lose it. They enter into drugs. You see. So
when was your turn around? What happened to you?
It wasn't something big, but it was a turn around that I managed to find a job and I managed to find a place. Then, obviously, continue with the things that I wanted. Not all of them that has been accomplished, but I managed to do the most.
And you are a musician also.
Precisely.
So I want to hear one of the hits. I mean, I listen to some like, what? Wow. So you guys, you must go out there, but we will give you the information of where you can get his music. So how is your music going?
So far, so good. Everything is going well.
Give me one of your favorite. I know you artists, you don't have favorite song, but one of the songs that you say, hey, shh. And I believe these songs, you write them from experience, right?
Most of them, I write them from experience and other people's experience. So there's a popular one that I did on my album. Obviously, I named the album with it, the Bless My Hustle. So the song is into two, it's divided into two.
Okay.
Bless My Hustle, and at the same time thanking God for the things that he has done for
me. Yeah. Is it a hip-hop?
It's a hip-hop quite a song.
Okay, let's do it.
I'm gonna teach you.
Okay. I'm listening.
Gonna teach you.
Okay, teach me.
Dear God, dalang kalang iwangvuka manje ndo discard some, please bless my hustle. Success what I need, you know what I mean.
Wow.
Dear God, dalang kalang iwangvuka manje ndo discard some, please bless my hustle.
Okay, let me try that. Okay, now. Let's leave.
Some other time, maybe.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, so the music is going places.
Yeah, no, the music is doing very well. I don't want to lie. Knowing the struggle before and compared to what's happening now, for me, it's doing very well.
I just want to ask you this question. How did you feel the first time when you drove your own car? Looking back at what you went through, how did it feel to you? The reason why I'm asking this, because you are an inspiration. And for me, as I sit here and listen, there's just so many things that I'm learning to say. We should not judge.
Asking me for that. I remember the first time,
you
know, having those keys, entering the car, and seated like that. I'm like,
is it me?
God, are you serious right now?
Are you serious right now?
Is it me?
Clash, freak.
Is it me or I'm dreaming, you know? So, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
It was one of those experiences.
We will be right back and we continue with Colin the General. Indeed, this is a show to watch and I'm having a good time in the studio. But please do not go away because we are coming back and we're going to unfold even more of Colin. Stay tuned.
Bo, 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 bo.
Bo, bo, bo.
I'm the general, love us niggas, kunzas, gag manga, kantulam, wheeler, ha. I caught you lang, albalel, bepon, and min wapa. Bakishima, sincha, sampas, wabon, hitting our side. It's about time, pijamas, and saluta, let's go. Totan and Totan, really, man, no more favors, I'm coloco. As no one's a chan in Salibelo, which you coloco. Shanamuka, look at Berlin's cancer, sissy manche. Sampana, simple, but Sula, San Gujani, manche. Berlin, a long time. King the general, so can I call up my MIA? Go ahead, you want to pass me in a sun and hamper and stop. Next thing, we saw Papa Matuana sang top. To one ten, the Kuranami, Walshani, Langani, Jotana, Namakan, and some more shells cut some. Said Melanin, attend your wooden fields to some. Yeah. nakanawuthwa eshile nifani nihambe ngibizi security bouncer safuna ukuthenza iparito kenge zokalawa athi kumele wenza show somela cause imhlala i-counter oyiletha ngimngiyiletha phekhathi nithanda ukufosta ngizothila nani jojot indaba I'm losing money he said you know me navele ngumuntu wabohane ophayo kuyasikhululu yosubuye papa temkhosa nganalaka ngithi uyezo.
Welcome back, everybody. If you have missed the first part, please make sure that you go watch it over again and subscribe to our channel. Still with me in the studio, Colin the General. Bo, 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 bo. Colin.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me about your music because I see you are also an artist.
Yes.
What did you do in your music and when did you start? And just take me through the journey of your music.
Yes, music started back at home at the early age. Mm-hmm. Like I said, entertainment was just in my head.
Mm-hmm.
So I was active everywhere, church, school, even at home when we play, we're doing the same thing. Doing ingoma, singing on Stratamia, on the choir at school. There's all obviously choirs at church. Mm. So there was a lot of singing and entertainment. And we were also doing all those things, sketches, drama. So you have to sing at school.
So that's where your music
that's
actually...
That's where the music started.
What inspired you to go into music?
A lot of things, you know, when growing up, just open your eyes in front of the home that there's a lot of singing and dancing.
Yeah.
That's where I grew up. My father was doing the same thing, like the church as well, where we grew up, because we were always at church. So that's where this thing started. But along the way, I have to take a decision, which one is mine, what I want to do with this lot of talents in me. Then I decided to go with the hip-hop.
You are multi-talented, I can tell you right now. Like, what comes to your mind when I say Drunkard Wild Donkey Entertainment?
Yep. Yeah. That was the first record label that I was signed at.
When was that?
That was around 2008. Somewhere there.
2008.
It's been a long way. Sometimes you even forget the years. You will be given a song. Do you still remember this song? You don't even remember the year.
Exactly. But so, something also, a dark cloud happened in your life where you find yourself depressed, hospitalized. What happened?
As a man, sometimes when things doesn't go your way, we fail to speak out. Sometimes we keep things inside. So when things not going your way, you're just thinking it will be fine, it will be fine, but I'm not telling anyone. Then finding myself there. So I think the noise inside me was too much. Yeah, it was too much.
So you were depressed and hospitalized?
Yes.
So is it because of what you were going through, you're trying to be strong and don't find anyone to talk to?
I was doing my best to be strong and not talking to anyone about what was going through in my life by that time. Because I was just having that hope, things will be fine, things will be fine. But it wasn't the way I expected. Yes.
And at that time, what was going on in your mind? Were you thinking, I'd rather die than really to go through what I'm going through? Or what was really going on in your mind at that time?
In my mind, there was just that voice that was saying, it will be fine, it will be okay, just be strong. You can do this, you can do this. But the energy was low by the time.
It was no longer there.
Yes.
So in hospital, did you have family that came to visit you, or even there you were on by yourself?
Fortunately, the brothers were with me by that time, yes.
So somebody's sitting there and he's a man and he's going through a lot in their life. What will you say to them?
Speak out.
Speak out.
Speak out. Don't keep it to yourself.
Find somebody.
Yeah, if it's that time to step back, you'll find a way forward. It's like,
so would you agree to say it's okay to cry, even being a man, when you feel things are 100%,
it's okay.
Because I believe many men out there, bakhuliswe with that thing to say, a man should not cry, you know, and...
It's not like that. In our dreams, yes, but in real life, it's a different story.
And especially, we expect a lot, especially kids, wives, parents, from a man. And when we don't see that also, we sometimes put pressure, you know, to you to say, hey, ndoda, provide, hey, the kids. And is those one of the things also that was going on in your life,
exactly,
where you had so much pressure?
Exactly. You just wish someone can say, I can see. What you're going through, but no one saying that. Everybody is expecting something out of you.
But also that voice that was coming telling you that you can make it, is it because you were so much believing in the music, or were you attending some sessions somewhere at some point of your life where these words were coming back, or how was it coming in your life where it says, don't give up, you can do this?
I think I miscalculated the stages.
Oh, come on. Say that again. That is just too powerful.
I miscalculated the stages. I was looking back and I'm like, okay, I did 1, 2, 3. So how can I fail now? Then I forgot that the levels are not the same. That time I was just a young boy coming into Joburg. Everybody looking at me, I look at that young man. But getting old, nobody's looking at you that way. So there's a lot of things that they are differ on that level.
Wow, that is so emotional, really. But I just like the way you just open up, you know, to say men must learn to speak.
No, definitely.
They must learn to, they must just find somebody. Because sometimes finding the right person to talk to can also be challenging.
It can help as well. So that comes back to the listeners as well, that let's pay attention to whoever is coming out to you and need to be listened. Nothing more, just to listen.
Okay, now I'm going to ask you another question and to break the ice, because this is just too emotional. Some little bird was singing and running around somewhere, and you know, this little bird told me something that you've got four baby mamas.
I feel like saying pop, 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 but I'm not going to say. Yeah.
Okay. What's happening there? Okay.
I won't promote that, but it happened to me, you know, always being on the road. So, yeah, sometimes you find yourself in one of these situations where, yeah, the baby mamas are coming out.
Did you do the DNA, or you just said bring them? Yeah.
Sometimes the DNA needed, you know. Sometimes you know.
You're like, I love an anamilo.
Sometimes you know.
But I'm glad that you are able to take care of them. And have you learned a lesson out of that?
Yes, I did learn a lesson, and the taking care of the kids, it's one of my priorities. So, that I won't make a mistake.
Awesome.
I won't make a mistake.
2020, 2021, lockdown happened, but you boomed. Huh? We saw you on screens everywhere, and you're like, who is this guy? When we are locked down, he just came out.
Yeah, that time, I think that God has shown me so many times that he's capable.
Come on.
Yes, but that time, it was too much. He showed me something different that I can surprise you. When people are crying, when people are saying we have no job, especially the entertainers, artists, were suffering, and boom, then I was everywhere, each and every channel. While everybody's crying, we're still waiting for
somebody's asking, what is this guy doing on TV? You're talking about TV, because like you were all over our screens.
I was that guy who can spoil your movie, who can spoil your whatever that you are watching on TV, because when it breaks time, you're gonna see my face.
So you were doing those adverts. Yes, and what adverts were you doing?
It was Dial Direct.
This is the guy behind Dial Direct. Okay, give me that advert. Do the advert. Mm. Your insurance.
Yeah, that was me, you know, looking at the traffic cop and I'm like, okay.
Okay. That look real. That looks so real.
Yeah. So I was so blessed with that advert. Yes, I was so blessed.
And that has lifted you
a lot.
So, what is the future plan? Where to from here?
Oh yes. Obviously, the hustle must continue. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. More auditions to come. And also on the music side, working with the legends right now. I'm working on my EP.
Okay.
That will be feature a lot of artists, likes of Bongo Riot, Zeddy Swag, and many more. I'm still working on it. And yes, so
you're going places,
I'm also
brother.
Pushing a big single that has been done by Zeddy Swag. Called Sigelela, Nkosi Sigeleli Sizwe. I'm sure people have heard that one. Yes. Yeah, so that's what coming up. And
somebody sitting out there and they're going through the hardest time of their life, what message can you tell them? Because today we look at you as the celebrity. You are a businessman. You are an artist. You are an actor. You are all this. And you told us that you've really worked so hard to be where you are. Somebody out there is really going through a lot in their life. What will you say to them?
Don't forget to pray. And secondly, there is someone out there who's waiting just to help. Someone out there is waiting to help you. So don't take anyone for granted, whoever comes in front of you, that person might come in handy. So your help is out there.
So rise up.
Rise up, go and get it.
And also one important thing that you said, understand the steps.
Understand the steps.
It's not going to happen overnight.
It won't. Once you miscalculate, you'll find yourself at the beginning.
And start
over. And you have to climb again. So make sure you calculate accurately.
And what will you say to people that really say advices? And find that some advices are not good. Do you normally take them and when you get home and say, this one, delete. This one,
Yeah, it's like that. I always work with that sequence where when I come to the gym, I was told that empty your cup, go inside, then fill everything, go outside, then you'll see what works for you.
Wow.
You're taking from the cup.
Wow.
The good and the bad.
Wow, that is too powerful. A final word from you. To our listeners, what is your final word?
Again, let's not forget to pray. God will surprise you, and also working hard can pay. Yes.
So you have to work hard to be where you are.
You have to work hard.
Wow. Thank you so much for coming. This was emotional for me. It took me back to understand life even better. And just to encourage somebody out there to say that, don't sleep, there is help out there.
There is help out there.
Work hard.
Work hard.
Pray.
Pray. God will answer. Wow. But once again, boo, 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 boo.
Yeah, we're doing this, my brother. Wow. Thank you so much for watching us today. And we are so grateful that you stayed with us this long to watch this show. From me to you, I love you. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and of course, hit that notification button. We are One Africa Radio TV.com. And if you want to catch us, please do so in all our social media. We are One Africa Radio TV. From me to you, we love you. And Colin the General, thank you, my brother.
Thank you so much.
Peace.
Dear God, darling, calling you on Google, manage to discard some, please bless my heart. Success, what I need, you know what I mean. Thank God Almighty, ngoku ngiqina thuku sonke. Langa seliphumile namasanga afulekile. Preaching the word of God, now indlela ngibonile. Kuqenge tolo phansi ngilimemeza.